Okay, my dear students, now let us talk about the factors upon which atomic size depends. So let us talk about the factors affecting atomic size. It's very easy, very simple. Number of shells that depend upon atomic sizes, atomic radii depends upon number of shells and nuclear charge. So these atomic radii, atomic sizes depend upon number of shells and nuclear charge. Okay, number of shells, how does it depend upon number of shells? Very simple. Hydrogen has only one shell, helium has two shells, lithium has three shells. So by the very orbital structures of these different elements, you can say that which one will be bigger in size, which one will have a greater atomic radius. Because more are the number of shells, more is the distance between the center of the nucleus and the outermost shell, so more greater is the atomic size. So here the distance will be from the center to the outermost shell, here the distance will be center from the center of the nucleus to the outermost shell, and here as well the distance will be from the center of the nucleus to the outermost shell. So you can observe the differences between the sizes. So number of shells, how does it depend? So number of shells, more is the number of shells, greater is the atomic size. Very easy. Now let us talk about the second factor, that is nuclear charge. Be focused and concentrated. Okay, some of the terms, some of the concepts are quite critical, but it's easy. Okay, critical in the sense that you have to use your head to understand nuclear charge. But if you understand all of these concepts, then you can answer any question. Don't mug up, no need of mugging up. Just understand and learn the concepts. Nuclear charge. What is nuclear charge? Nuclear charge means number of protons in the nucleus. This is nuclear charge. That is nothing but the atomic number A. Okay. Sorry, Z. The atomic number Z. So the number of protons in the nucleus of an atom is the nuclear charge, and that is equal to the atomic number. So how does it affect the atomic size? It affects the atomic size. Let us take an example to understand this. Let us take the second period. Lithium, beryllium, boron. Let us take the first three elements of the second period. Nuclear charge. So the atomic number of lithium is 3. Atomic number of beryllium is 4. Boron is 5. And as they belong to the second period, leave it aside. Then we will talk about it later on. So the atomic number of lithium is 3. It has 3 protons in the nucleus, in its nucleus. It has 4 protons in its nucleus. It has 5 protons in its nucleus. So more is the number of protons in the nucleus, more is the strength of the nucleus. And you know that the nucleus is positive, you know that nucleus is positive, nucleus of any atom is positive because it contains protons and neutrons. Neutrons are neutral charge and no charge, zero charge, and protons are positively charged. So the overall charge of nucleus is positive. And the electrons which revolve around the nucleus in different orbits are negatively charged, isn't it? They are negatively charged. So, and you have studied since your childhood that opposite charges attract each other, isn't it? Opposite charges attract each other. So, what happens when the strength of this nucleus, this positive nucleus, increases? It will pull the electrons strongly. It will pull the electrons towards itself strongly. So more is the number of protons, more is the atomic number, more is the strength of the positive nucleus, more strongly it pulls the electron towards itself. And more it pulls, the size shrinks. The size, more the size shrinks, isn't it? So more is the atomic number, more is the number of protons, more is the nuclear charge, positive charge of the nucleus, more strongly the nucleus pulls the electron towards itself, and the size shrinks. And the size shrinks, matlab size decreases. So what is the effect of the nuclear charge then? More is the nuclear charge, more is the nuclear charge, more, sorry, lesser is the atomic size. Hope you understood.